Okay, I am back. This is the 8th, part 8 of my spiritual experiences. I think it will be the last part as far as I now know. Of course, there is in general more experiences that I can tell, but otherwise it's too much. I already have told so much in the last 7 parts, it's specific about my spiritual experiences. So, and then I have in the other category about remote viewing and out of body. I have also a couple of videos released. So yeah, there is a lot of information about my experiences. Now available because it's very important that I talk about it, and so yeah, it's people can maybe recognize it here and there with their own experiences. But it's not only that, the reason why I release this information, it's also because of I must say researchers maybe can have an interest, to investigate. I mean, genuine researchers, and also about my message to higher top levels of control structures who are in that field. Also about the nature of reality, and other dimensions and with entities. So that many people have these experiences, let's say the genuine experiences, okay, and the also manipulated ones, as I told before. That can be some information you can put in your head, but these events are real, okay. It's just some of them can be genuine and some of them can be manipulated without you knowing it. It's possible, but okay, I will go further on my experiences. And this one was like in a dream, also a couple of, I think it was around 2009 or 2010, if I'm not mistaken. I will keep the video short, okay, because my battery can be low, or the amount of space on my memory card cannot be that big. If the video falls out, it falls out, okay, that's it. But I will post this video anyway. So yes, I think around 2010, possible around 2010, I was it was like in a dream, okay, and I saw a second sun in the sky. It was like a clear sky, okay, no clouds. I mean, I saw two suns in the sky, and on that moment, I was looking at the sky. I saw these two suns. More, there is nothing more to it. Only just that look, that image, and then I woke up. It's possible it can be a vision. It's very possible, but later on, I did not know what it was, and later on, some information come to me. Not that I looking for it. It came to me, and I saw signs says in the near future, and that was after a couple of weeks after that I had that experience. A couple of weeks or months, I don't know. After that experience, and then I saw an article on the internet that science says there will be in near future a second sun visible in the sky. Now, what was that that all about? They speak about supernova. I have my own opinion about it. That it's just another disinformation, because when it could happen, then people will say, hey, yeah, it's maybe that what science says, you know, a supernova. That's and it will be, they say it will be for a long period of time visible. And it, I don't know if they mentioned that the daylight will be a little bit longer. I don't know, but it was at the same side of the sun. Okay, as I see it, of course I look came across information about this situation, and I felt what is it that I saw? What I saw in my so-called vision. I was looking at information also then afterwards, you know, and listen to people who speak about other situations in that field, you know, the UFO field. But then some of them says about this second sun, you know, that will be visible in the sky, but they say it's Nibiru that will return. It's like in a kind of cycle. And it will be at the same side of our sun, so when it's daylight, you can see it very clearly. It's like a second sun, and others says it will be a second actual sun. That will be the same thing like cycles, you know, that happens over thousands of years, you know. So I'm just saying that these are possibilities. To consider, and whatever it can be, what's up there. But another man was also talking about that, also somebody who worked for the government, you know, in that secret field, and he says that he told his colleague, you know, why there are most of the satellites out there are pointed to blank space, and his colleague says, "If I tell you, then you will be dead." No, in other words, if I have understood it in that way, what he says, if it is correct, but what he meant is that it is normally is I need to know. So you cannot know this information. If you know it, they find it out, you will be dead, you know. So that says a lot, you know, about secret information, and the most dangerous thing above ignorance is secrecy, and that's the most dangerous thing you can do. So you can keep some things secret for a amount of time, you know, for the safety and for not to have chaos, you know, chaos around it. But we have also secrets that is normally in a way to control the population, and in another way, you know, that is not that is effect against us. So it depends about which secrecy you're talking about. But yeah, it's very interesting. And another experience I had, but also about this second sun in these Star Wars movies. When I was younger, I saw these movies also, of course, but I never reminded me of that same situation, because in that movie, in the older movies, Skywalker was walking to the sky. in that direction, and he saw two suns in the sky, in that movie. Okay, so could it be a message that Hollywood sends out, you know, of the one who controls Hollywood, you know, to send a kind of message out, or talking they about another solar system they know of who have a second sun? Who knows? You know, it's just strange. But okay, it's like dots. You must look at the dots, you know, and you can connect them, because they have probably a connection with each other. That's how I see it. And then you can have a clearer view on the situation. Okay. Okay. Now about another experience, and that was I cannot say the time. No, I don't remember the year. It's a couple of years ago, but I don't remember the year. But it was about also in a dream kind of state. I will continue to talk about my experiences. Okay, when the video falls out, it falls out. No, it's I post it. You know, and if there comes a part 9, then there will be a part 9. Otherwise, part 8 will be the last one. Okay, then I will keep to continue with my other experiences under another name. Again, then I start with part 1 again. But okay, so in that dream. You know, I was and the dream was very real. I mean, actual, real. I was in a high building, and I was walking. I don't know what I was doing there, but suddenly something happened. I was looking outside my window, and I saw a nuclear weapon. Let's say an atomic bomb went off, a big one. You know, and of course, right away my direct reaction was like this, but I know I cannot escape from it. You know, it's done. But I knew better because I know that whatever happens, you know, if I am gone here, my consciousness still exists. So that I knew. But I closed my eyes. You know, I felt the wave coming. It did not hurt anything. Nothing hurt. You know, nothing collapsed or something. But it did came. The wave, I felt it in a way, and then I saw my eyes were closed, and then I saw a yellow kind, purple, light purple kind of color, and it's like I lifted up. More I do not know. So that's very interesting. But later on, right away, I thought that something to do with Mars. It's just a possibility, okay? Because later I found it out. That on Mars, science says, you know, that on Mars, possible that there is evidence that there is a nuclear war was going on there, on some places, you know, on Mars, and that's the reason why Mars is destroyed. So the atmosphere, you know, and the oceans and nature. So yes, always said. Felt deep inside that there was nuclear war, nuclear situation there. So, not once, but let's say at the same time, you know, some atomic bomb went off up there. It's just a feeling that I have. No, and when I have that feeling, and then you come across this information that science says, you know, that a couple atomic bombs went off on Mars. That long ago, so in the far past. So is this coincidence? No, I don't think so. That's my feeling about it. And then I have, and before that I had this dream kind of, it could be a memory, it's possible to relive this situation. But it was very real, I can say this, you know. If somebody says, oh, you have never seen an actual atomic bomb went off. But this experience was like that, you know, very real. But okay, then my other, I will continue with my experiences. The other experiences that I had, and that was in 2011, if I'm not mistaken. If I am not mistaken, it was with higher dimensions. Also at night, you know, when I sleep, and then sometimes I have these experiences. But this particular experience I had twice with a woman at the front. You know, I saw energy floating, yellow, purple kind of energy. Just checking my time. Okay, I will try to keep it in 5 minutes, you know. I saw energy, yellow, purple kind of floating, you know, and there was a woman in white, blonde hair, smiling at me, you know, with a light smile, and I felt this unconditional love, the same as people with a near-death experience, when they contact have with these higher dimensions. So it's the same feeling. You must know the feeling, you know, that that's what's important. So she did like this, you know, with her, yes, with her right hand, did like this. A beam of violet energy, purple energy came to me, and then I wake up. So that was the first experience in this life that I know of this kind of vibration. The second experience came shortly afterwards, I think. This time I cannot tell if it was the same woman, but she was much closer now. And again at night, you know, and then suddenly I have this experience. She stood there, you know, alone, blonde hair, white dress, the same kind of feeling, that unconditional love, you know. And then with her eyes half open, that was interesting, you know. She was just observing me. I was looking at this, you know, because that feeling was incredible high. It was an amazing feeling. Then suddenly I see at my right side a man appearing from out of nothing, you know. That was it was not coming like this, it was out of thin air. It just came the same way. So I look directly, I look right away at him, and he had a beard, brown hair. His skin was a little bit darker, like me. That woman was more white kind of skin, and I was looking at him. The same feeling, but I was more interested in her. My focus was more on her. So, but his eyes were also half open, and his clothes were like this kind of color, brown and light brown, like a Roman kind of look. Okay. I never saw the feet, you know, it's just from here on, I think that I can remember, not in detail, but I can remember it. And then, but I don't know, I was more interested in her. So I looking back at her, a few seconds later, he disappears as he came, you know. Then, before I knew it, I look at her right ear and I see a spiral earring. From that moment on, when I focused on it, the connection was disconnected. So, and then I woke up, I said to myself, why is the connection disconnected? Because I saw this spiral earring, but why? No, maybe I saw too much. I don't know, I still have questions about that. But it can be as possible, it's a possibility that man was me. My higher aspect, you know, in what we call future, higher dimensions, you know, that I was there. It could be, it's very interesting. That's why the connection, it was not the same as I was looking at her. So why I was more interested in her. And then another experience was, only two experiences of this, yes. So that's very interesting. And like I said, you know, in general, my experiences can come up in a short period of time, different experiences, and sometimes it can take months and even a year before I have other experiences, you know. So it's not that I am waiting for it, it just happens. Sometimes it's my attention to it, to reach the higher vibrations, or to connect with some entities. But anyway, if there is a part 9, I will create a part 9 of my spiritual experiences, otherwise this is the last one. So I will put this video out before it goes out from itself. So yes, I have told already a lot, you know, but I will continue with if there is no part 9 of my spiritual experiences, I cannot tell everything because it will be it's too much to tell. So, but 8 videos is already a lot, you know, of plus minus 20 minutes each video. But I will continue also with other experiences under another name, under with another name, and again with starting with part one and so on. So, see you then next time, and just be open to it and explore for information, or explore for information. It's very important that we do that. So, and also I will say this in the next part, what I will want to say now. But okay, see you then with the next video.